Good morning, students. Today we shall discuss about the contribution of Buddhism onto the Indian culture. What is our topic today? Contribution of Buddhism to the Indian culture. So in previous videos we talk about the life history of Lord Buddha and also discuss about the teachings of Lord Buddha. And what are the main principles of Buddhism? And what are the main principles are taught by the famous Buddhist monk? And also discuss about the categories of Buddhism. So this type of information can be discussed in previous video. Let it. Today I am going to explain about the contribution of Buddhism to the Indian culture and traditions. So students, it is also one of the most important short answer question in the annual examination point of view. So listen to me carefully and write the key points on your notes. Okay. So Buddhism was one of the famous religion during the time of BC 6th century, not only India but also another part of world. Why? Because it is contribute to the Indian culture and also impact of social life of the people of contemporary period, especially it was a most popular impact on our Indian society and Indian culture. Mainly it was impact on society, political, religion and art and architecture are influenced by the Buddhist trend and traditions. In that I mentioned some points here, you should write down. The first one, impact on Indian society by keeping its doors open, Shudras and women. What is the first point? Impact on Indian society, Indian social conditions. What are they? The doors open to the Shudras and women. Why? Because during the time of BC 6th century, the woman position was very worst in the society. Shudra's position also worst in the society because the Varnashrama system was dominated in the Indian society. Brahmins and Kshatriyas are dominated their power on the society. The Indian society can be divided into hierarchical system. In the hierarchical system, the Shudras were lower caste in the position. Their life was looked like a slavery. Their position was in worst. That's why the Buddhism was opposed to the Varnashrama system of Hindu culture. And also Buddhism encouraged the women's and their position. By the influence, by the help of Buddhism, the Shudras and women's are great progressed of their position in the society. So it is great impact. And second, the doctrine of Ahimsa. What is Ahimsa? It is nothing but non-violence. Ahimsa was becoming from the Buddhist principles. Non-violence is the main preaching of Lord Buddha. This principle was much more expansion of the Indian society. Because in those days, the Vedic rituals and sacrifices are conducted by the rulers and the Brahmins, especially. When the rituals and sacrifices are conducting, a number of animals like cows, cattle, etc. are killed in that ceremonies. That's why the wealth of cattle was day to day in decrease. In that, the agriculture system was collapsed. Why? Because the cattle was used in agriculture sector. The influence of Buddhism, the cattle wealth was day to day grown up. Everyone should be followed the principle of Ahimsa of Buddhism. And third, promoted trade and commerce. Buddhism promoted trade and commerce, either internal trade or external trade. It was also one of the most impact of Buddhism on Indian society. Buddhism encouraged the trade and commerce. Why? Because it is expansion is not only our country, it is also expanding foreign countries also. A number of foreigners are visited our country and they were moved to one place to another place in our Indian region and they were meet the merchants and traders and they should be developed their trade network with Indian merchants. That's why the trade relations are developed between India and another countries by the influence of Buddhism and its expansion. Okay, students. Next one, Buddhism developed new awareness in the field of intellect and culture. Buddhism developed a new awareness in the field of intellectual and culture, especially. దీన్నే మనం తెలుగులో హేతువాద దృక్పథం అంటాం. ఇట్ షుడ్ బి డెవలప్డ్ బై ద బుద్ధిజం. బిఫోర్ ద ఎస్టాబ్లిష్మెంట్ ఆఫ్ బుద్ధిజం టోటల్ హిందూ కల్చర్ వేదిక్ కల్చర్ వాజ్ డిపెండ్ ఆన్ ద యాన్షియంట్ ట్రెడిషన్స్. అబ్నార్మల్ traditions, unconscious trends are filled by the Indian society. After the establishment of Buddhism, it is questioned to the untraditional conditions of the Indian culture. That's why a new awareness was developed onto the Indian people. Next, fifth one, Buddhism broke the isolation of India and established an intimate contact between India and the rest of the world. Buddhism broke the isolation of India. Before the existence of Buddhism, India was totally isolated. It has no relations to the rest of the world. But the existence of Buddhism, it is broken. The Buddhism was encouraged the network of India with the neighboring countries and rest of the world. How it is broke the isolation of India? It is encouraged by the rulers. A number of Buddhist monks and saghas goes to foreign countries and explain the principles of Lord Buddha in that areas. By the influence of the principles of Lord Buddha and famous Buddhist monks, the foreigners are coming to our visited to country and they are also influenced by the Buddhism principles. They were maintained a new relations between India and the foreign countries. So that's why the isolation of India was broken. So this is the main contribution of the Indian Buddhism on Indian society. And Indian art and architecture also. influenced by the Buddhism principles. It is one of the finest and greatest impact of Buddhism on Indian trends. That's why I mentioned here, it is finest contribution of Buddhism onto the art and architecture. In that, I mentioned some of most striking examples here of the influence of art and architecture. Write down the students. The first one is, a number of stupas and stone pillars depicting the life of Buddha at Sanchi, Barhat and Gaya. Stupas are the holy places or pilgrim centers of the Buddhist people. A number of stupas are constructed various period in various regions of our country. In that, a famous stupas are constructed in Sanchi, Barhat and Gaya. These are big and most popular stupas in our country, not only country, in the world. On the walls of the stupas, the stone pillars depicting the life of Lord Buddha. Vati paina Lord Buddha ki sambandhinchinatvanti life story contents mottam depicting on the pillars of the stupas. It is very fine. And another most of the contribution of art and architecture is cave architecture. This is also most important contribution of art and architecture of Buddhism in Indian culture. Where it is found? Barabar caves at Gaya and Western Ghats in Maharashtra, like Ajanta, Ellora caves, and Nasik Karle Kanheri in central part of India. Here also a number of caves architecture are influenced by the Buddhism. In our Telugu speaking regions like Andhra Pradesh and Telangana, here also a number of stupas, viharas and cave type of architecture have been found in archaeological excavations. In AP, Battibrolu and Danya Katakam. These are the most important Buddhist centers of in Andhra Pradesh region. In Telangana, Kotilangala, Dhulikatta, Kondapur, it is in Medak district, Fanigiri, it is in Nalgonda district, and Geeskonda, it is in Warangal district. These centers also most popular for the Buddhist pilgrim centers. And also one of the finest contribution of art and architecture of Buddhism is develop the Gandhara art. It is coming in further in it. We shall discuss in detail in that part. Where is Gandhara? Gandhara is the northwest part of India. Now it is Afghan and Pakistan border. So it is also developed by the Buddhism only. So this is the information about the contribution of Buddhism to the Indian culture. Tomorrow we shall